All right, so there's a problem with my key, so I'm waiting for the security guy to come up and give me a new key card. I probably magnetized it with a cell phone or something like that. I'm back from day 2.5 of Gnomedex, and it's another full day of presentations and such. A little bit of a different assortment than yesterday, of course, but today's highlights, Ethan Kaplan, who works for Warner Brothers Music, did a fantastic presentation about how fans should be hierarchically as important as the artists in the music world, and what does Warner Brothers do, and how do they conduct a marketing campaign, and how decisions are made. And he's particularly adept about REM, and are you a security person?
I am.
Oh, I'm 608. I'm looking for a key.
Okay, I just need to verify your ID with them.
Oh, yeah,
with
totally.
The desk. It's new
turn. Oh, yeah. Hold on, I'm just...
You said 606, right?
608.
608, I'm sorry.
Yeah. There's me.
Okay.
Don't mind me, I'm just talking to my video camera.
Hey, I need the last name for 608.
Oh, I'm getting checked out. So Ethan Kaplan did his thing, and he's an REM fan and used to tour with REM and promote them and drug them kicking and screaming onto the internet.
David.
Oh, I'm getting checked
out. Okay, gotcha.
Okay. Moment of panic. I just extended the room for another day, another night today. So
the reason the key's not working because it cancels out on the day that it's supposed to check out. So you'd
okay.
So if you should have access.
Oh, that's the one I need.
So that's what happens when it checks out. So, am I doing that? My room's not working.
That's about where I'm at too. It's been a long day.
I'll have a new key and I'll bring it right back to you.
Okay, fantastic. Thanks
okay,
so much.
I'll be back in about 2 minutes.
All right. So also today, Tara Hunt and Chris Messina. And Tara met at Mind Camp last year, and she's born in Saskatoon and kind of a new marketing pundit of sorts. But unlike many people, she's very positive and enthusiastic about the opportunities for small and kind of independent-y sized business. So her and her real-life husband, Chris, a.k.a. Factory Joe, where's the light, have started a company called Citizen Agency. And they're encouraging businesses to stay small, and by finding their own niche, they don't have to compete against the 800-pound gorilla. We can have 80 10-pound spider monkeys instead, which I'm all in favor of more spider monkeys. And then Dave Weiner had spoke this morning. I missed his spiel, but apparently he talked about some exciting things of where he thinks things are going. And Dave Weiner's kind of a grumpy old dude, as we found during the Blake Ross from Firefox's presentation. Dave was getting a little bit surly and emotional and personal, and was getting all tense. But then Chris Pirillo did a spiel kind of talking about whether or not he should try to fund TagJag, which is his Gotta Be, which is kind of a tag aggregator, news aggregator for mobile devices. It goes around and finds all these different checks all these different publishing things and feed generator things, and kind of, well, give you some results. It's a little bit hard to explain clearer than that right off the bat, but that was mildly interesting. And what else? That's all I can remember right now. But later on, next up is going to EMP, which is Paul Allen's like music museum kind of thing, and I'm really excited about that because there's an art exhibit there called Double Take that's juxtaposing art from two different eras or two different stylistic conventions. Like, they'll put a Van Gogh next to a Darth Vader helmet or a Lichtenstein next to a Picasso, and allowing you to compare and contrast the different motivations for making art in different points in history. There's something else. Oh, there's been a lot of news in hockey, so I'm going to try and record a little bit of hockey news later on with Darren Barefoot, and it was a fun singing O Canada today. That was definitely a highlight. And all the Canadians got cupcakes. And they weren't the tastiest cupcakes, but it was a very nice gesture. So, namaste and happy Canada, 136 years old.